I'd like to thank Moot for sponsoring this video and helping me throughout the apocalypse. So Moot is a platform that helps you stay up to date on a large selection of games from PUBG to League to, most importantly for us, Overwatch. It's a platform full of other players who want to grow with the games that they're playing with their community, and Moot really provides a lot of opportunities for this, such as checking fellow players' posts, upvoting them, commenting, or by using the lounge system, which you can check out right here. There's a level up system that will reward you for sharing, voting, and discussing with each other, and overall I think it's a great place to hear what the community's saying if you're looking for somewhere that does that. Right now it's available on PC, iOS, and Android, so if you get the chance and feel like this sounds exciting to you at all, make sure to check out the link in the description below. So the first week of Overwatch League has come and gone, and overall there's been a lot more exciting games than most of us thought that there was going to be in the first place. A lot of people were kind of sleeping on Overwatch League, but it's been a great time with Dallas Fuel versus the Korean Seoul team, and just even Pine popping off on Elias with McCree. That was exciting and something none of us could really expect to happen. But one problem that I feel like a lot of people are kind of talking about right now is a problem that a lot of esports has seen for just forever, and that is the Korean player issue. And personally, I feel like it can be an issue that we should talk about a little bit, get out of the water, and then continue to enjoying the game and enjoying the league and just getting past this as quickly as possible, because yes, this has happened with every esport that I've really ever watched, so I want to address it and try to get past it. So personally, with a lot of these players, I'm going to say that I think that the best player for the job should get the job. If you are the best player and you apply for a New York team and you're better than all the local New York players, I think you should be able to get in there, and that's how it should kind of work. But that can be kind of frustrating for a lot of fans, and I feel like for a lot of people, they're okay with a certain amount of players to come in. They're okay with like 4 or 5 Korean players to take the roster, but for many players, it can be kind of frustrating to have your entire roster be taken from a foreign player and from a foreign country. For a lot of people, it's hard to root for someone that wasn't homegrown, and I know that that can sound kind of bad, but that's just kind of how sports has always been in literally everything. People just like to see their players that came up from the bottom at their own hometown and are now dominating the world stage, and it's kind of hard to do that when the majority of your players, like in the London or in the New York team, aren't in that situation. And I feel like for most people, they are definitely okay with having Korean players join your team, with having Korean players enjoy the matches and make the matches elevate to a higher level. I just think a lot of fans have problems with having only Korean players being imported and being the real big stars of your team and not giving anybody locally a chance. That's what I feel like a lot of fans have a problem with, and I don't know, maybe some of these local teams could help a little bit with that. But again, I do feel like if these players are the best, they should get the job. But I think that's kind of how you can see that the fans would get a little disappointed not having somebody that, you know, they can really root for that came from their hometown. Now, something else I want to also mention about this is that a lot of people are kind of asking, why not just change these two teams to Korean teams? And I think that's kind of a hard question to answer, because while yes, I think any team from anywhere should be allowed to, you know, take any player and have them join your roster, it's also kind of difficult to argue to just not make two more Korean teams and add them to the roster and replace these teams, as they are probably what the team rosters would be anyways. Personally, I probably even like that happening, because there isn't that much Korean roster. There's only one team that's allowed to be in the league, and maybe having some more competition from the best players in the world in general would be kind of nice, and having them come from their own hometown could also be kind of nice for those players. But I guess, leave in the comment section down below, what would you guys do in that situation? Now, other than that, let me just swoop down to the past a little bit, because I feel like this will kind of explain what's also going on right now. For a long time in the past, Koreans have generally been some of the best esport players, and I feel like the perfect example of this, because it's another Blizzard game that Koreans were really great at, was StarCraft 2. The majority of the best players came from Korea. Of course, other regions did still do pretty well, but there were just a lot more hits coming from that region. Now, another thing I want to mention, though, before we kind of continue in this, is that while there have been a lot of Korean players and a lot of Korean teams doing really, really well in esports, and especially in, like, League, replacing a lot of different players, for the most part in the past, as far as history has shown, there has always been more local players that have eventually stepped up to the plate and eventually caught up well enough in skill that they can get into that team, start off as a, you know, off player, somebody on the bench, but eventually get up onto the big screen and play really well from there. I feel like you shouldn't think just because the teams are this way right now, they will always be that way. And if you're a person that wants to have a mixture of Koreans and your local players, don't be too dissatisfied with your current team. Be okay with voting for them. Be okay with shouting for them and just enjoying when your local team wins. it's not too bad, and eventually, in a lot of cases, your own players might be able to eventually get in there and be able to do pretty well in their own matches. A thing I want to say about this is that Koreans are currently really, really good at a lot of games, and I'm not against that at all. That's perfectly fine. But they haven't been the best at every single esport ever, and there still is a lot of chance for a lot of players to grow and improve, and I feel like these Korean players will help a lot of players improve by putting them through a lot of practice. Throughout all time, throughout a lot of esports, especially a lot of shooters, they haven't always been the best. With Call of Duty, of course they don't really like that game that much, but we haven't seen them way too much right there. CSGO, there's been mainly European teams and some American teams, so I haven't seen them there way too much either. And in Smash Brothers, America, Japan, and of course, South America have been some of the strongest regions, with one of the best players coming from Chile. So, you know, every single game's a little bit different. And I feel like in Overwatch, there's one thing that you kind of want to remember, and that's that a lot of these games are closer than in other games. In League, I feel like for the most part, we're seeing huge blowouts from the Korean teams. SKT, almost every year at the Worlds, except for this year, which I think Samsung White won this year. But SKT and Samsung have been doing amazing. They just kind of blow everybody else out of the water. But Overwatch has been a lot closer, and Overwatch has had a lot more good games, I feel like, between these teams. And the regions are a lot closer, and I feel like that's something that you can kind of keep in mind. I feel like there is room for the people that are local to improve and to hopefully catch up and to hopefully join these teams and join their local Korean players in these matches and be able to hopefully do pretty well in there and maybe give some local pride to that. And overall, I'm going to say that yes, it can be very frustrating as a fan of your state. Let's say you're in New York. It can be frustrating to try to support a team that you don't really know any players from, you don't really know any streamers from, your favorite content creators aren't really talking about them way too much. That might be kind of frustrating, but at the same time, I don't think that there should be a rule to force these players out. I think they should be allowed to play in that game, and I just hope that these teams actually allow a lot more local players to eventually join in once they catch up in skill bracket. There are so many good local players of this game, and I'm sure in the future there's going to be even more of these players kind of showing up. I'm hoping that by having these teams as they are right now, it'll boost a lot of people's confidence. It'll make a lot of people say, hey, I want to get into that team myself. I want to put in the work. I want to put in the practice. Let's get some more people like me in this team. And hopefully those local players are allowed to join. One thing that I am kind of afraid of happening in the near future is that, you know, the New York team or the London team or anything like that won't allow any local players to join. And, you know, this might just be fear-mongering in the future, and I really hope it isn't. And I hope that in the future, you know, these teams will allow any player to join. But I'm kind of afraid that they'll want to just keep only playing Korean players and only getting more and more of them and not really allowing any local talent to shine. I'm okay with both showing up, but I hope that they don't just butt out local players just to have the highest percent chance of winning every single match, because that could, you know, kind of be annoying again for a lot of the people that are trying to be fans of this team when their team won't even accept anybody that's trying to improve well enough to eventually join the team. But I mean, in the end, I guess this is just kind of how it goes. The best players will join the teams, the best players will try their best, and whoever ends up being the best in the end will start to play a little bit more. And one thing I'm going to say, I guess, is that if you're really, really against this, and if you really just want some local players into your games, you can also as well support a different team. If you're living in New York, but you don't want to see that, you can support Dallas Fuel. You can support, you know, wherever else you really want to. You can support the Valiants or whatever you want to do. There's nothing 100% holding you down to your current state. I know it can kind of feel like that sometimes. And as well, if you're somebody that's living out of the United States, you probably don't really care way too much either way. You're just going to pick your favorite team and play them as well. And if you are someone out of the United States and you don't even want that local pride, then I'm going to say just completely support these teams and just say, hey, pick up the best players and keep doing as you're doing, because I just want to see the best matches possible, because in the end, I feel like bringing in a lot of Korean players is going to bring the best matches possible. It's going to bring the most experienced players possible, as long as those Koreans are the best players at the current time and are the most experienced players at the current time. And I'm hoping that through enough games, everybody can equal out a little bit more and we can see just a lot more exciting games and see everybody just improve little by little until we can hopefully have just, you know, the best time that we possibly can. Anyways, that's all I'm going to say about this. If you guys have any of your own opinions, please do leave that in the comment section down below. I was trying to stay the most middle point possible, trying to support both sides, telling people's reasons why they are for this and why they're against this, so then you don't get angry at somebody in the future. And if you do get angry at me from this video, I'm sorry. Hope you'll forgive me. And hope that we can, you know, continue in the future and enjoy the game and enjoy the league. And I know you might kind of get hung up on this one fact and this one thing, but I hope that you don't, and I hope that you can just keep enjoying the games, honestly, because personally, they're some of the funnest things that I've seen so far in Overwatch. Anyways, as always, guys, though, thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, hit the subscribe button or the notification button. Tell me if you see any ways that I can improve these videos in the future. And as always, guys, though, have a wonderful day.